It's an unfinished version of the game. You might encounter broken or missing parts. Save games won't work with a final release. Oh, it's so gooey. Oh, this co-op. And you can turn off explosives or... Oh, I like that. Shared and split screen? Ooh, okay, okay. I'm kind of down for that. Let's go standard. Planet Nexus, centuries after the bleeding. Amongst remnants of old civilization. Humanity rests in silent pity. So, Warhammer. While machines wander, passing judgment. SJ, morning! And the outcasts try to survive. This is Death Trap. Is this the one about the monster? This one's good. What this one's about, actually? Empathy. Influences some interactions with the character. Allows the use of most forms of implants and techs. Bolt allows the use of abilities that communicate with the flesh. Allows the use of better range weapons. Allows the use of better melee and increases health. Oh, animalism. You know what? I wanna know the flesh. Bartering artistry. Creativity and a feel for special opportunities. Dialogue options, chat. So lockpicking? Template. Okay. Oh god, they do have co-carnage in here. And they got Zeke! No good facial hair, though. There you go. Perfect. Platinum Ratchet and Clank in 17 hours, and I'm the only one that's... Am I the only one that thinks that's really short? No, that sounds about right, actually. Oh, here we go. Space to roll. What is this machine? It looks... Trash. You picked up trash. You have... Trash. Yeah, this is not mine. Good to know. It's good to know. Good to know. Oh. Hello. Welcome, former citizen. It looks like their operation has been successful. Do you remember who you are? Yes, I do. That is fortunate. We still take interest in your well-being. However, you have to leave us now. The danger of a possible contamination cannot be ignored. Please don't try to return to your old habitat. We have put security measures in place to prevent this. What security? Your body will malfunction permanently when nearing one of our habitats. So what happens to me now? Where should I go? This is not for us to answer. You are free to go anywhere as long as you don't try to enter a habitat. Here is all relevant info for you in written form in case you forgot. We encourage you now to follow the surface integration course, but you're free to leave anytime you want. I'll take the course. All right. Let's continue towards the section one then. Locked. Wrong way? Yeah. Does not look like the one I was thinking about. The other one you play is a monster who consumes humans and gets out of control. Oh, you're talking about Carrion. Yeah, that's actually already out. The surface integration course is standard procedure to teach you basic survival. Please continue to be cautious. The course disables safety limits to better prepare you for the world outside. Good luck, former citizen, and goodbye. Okay. Oh, it's impossible. Missing lockpick. Oh, that's why. I got the skill. I just need the pick. What's the name of this? Death Trash. Yeah. We did play Unmetal, by the way, and oh my god, we are playing that come the game comes out. From the guys behind Unepic. Nano Hell. I couldn't heal myself up. Ooh, there we go. Pick up the light combat vest. Hit tab. Equip. Oh yeah, look at that. Take all. That's what I needed. Yeah, I needed trash. Yeah, that's exactly what I needed. This probably used to be a bed. Okay. That probably used to be a heart. That's an organ. What is this place? I don't know. Take the organs. That will come in handy. And we come late. It's health. They eat it raw. How many demos do we have in store? A few. I did not go overboard. They just showed too many good games. That's the problem. Not my problem. It's a them problem. That's what that problem is. Yes. But about 40. Yeah. 10 horror games, which we will put on horror commands. And about 31 normal ones. Yeah. Breya and the Last Dragon is phenomenal game, by the way. Or movie, by the way. Luca will be... Are we watching Luca tomorrow? But... Yeah, Raya... Raya is the type of game... Like, movie where I would love if they had a video game. Like, I was... Yeah. I dug the character. I think the biggest, though, is, like, I really, 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 really like the baby. Like, the con baby just made me just... But it's so good. Dragon I was a little wishy-washy with. It was like the world that I was like, ah, the world's just so cool looking. That's the thing. I love the way the world looks. Yeah. Went overboard? Not that overboard. Machine looks like it's connected to the door. Please refill organic lubricant. What the f*** is that supposed to mean? Looks like I could enter some self-made lubricant here. I don't have any yet. Use puke. Broken tools here, nothing you. Here we go. Oh, hey, it worked. It's active, apparently. That's cool. Pick up the weapon. I got a cudgel. At least I'm not the only one that thought that was just kind of... T to draw a weapon. Swing and a miss. Ooh, is there a way to remove that, like, thingy against the, screen shake? I'm not a fan of screen shake. Hang on. Let's see if I can, can I get rid of the screen shake? There's no way to get rid of that screen shake. Damn, okay. Smash the disgusting. I know. Smash it. Hold. Oh. This is so nasty. It's active. Of course it's active. It's always active. Watch the first episode of Loki. Really good. WandaVision, I like what they did with Wanda. It took a while for me to get into WandaVision. That was the thing. Oh! Like, I like where it went, but it was like so much easier for me to get into. How do I cycle again? Oh, there we go. It was easier for me to. I guess I got a target action with a weapon. Huh? Oh yeah. That's a weird way to open up a door, but sure, sure, sure. Ah, stealth technique. Click on the portrait. Click on the body. Click on the body. Click on the inventory. Click on the body. What? Okay, hang on. Click on the body tab. Oh, there it is. Derp. Got it. Okay, alt. Yo! You hear it? Oh, he hurts! Eat the red gooey stuff. Think about 4 episodes for we really pick up. Yeah, it. Once they got past the sitcom, I'm not much for a sitcom. Like, I have had friends who love like shows like Friends or The Big Bang Theory or Office or things like that, and I can't get into that stuff. Like, I really can't. I have straight up issues with those. Like, I just, not my thing. And so when I see, like, you know, Marvel sitcom, I'm kind of like, eh. Okay, maybe we're not supposed to fight them? Maybe you're supposed to only use ranged weapons on them, by the way. Yeah. Actually, I forgot what happened in to Loki to Infinite War. So it takes pretty good, cool spin on things. It does. I'm really positive the TVA is just bad guys, right? They give you the illusion of choice. Yeah. If you wake up, like, if you listen to that first episode and you hear that, like, little animated talk, like, you know, mascot, if you will, which is voiced by Tara Strong, which is awesome, by the way. Say you went to work late. Now you're variant because you should have gone there. Like, you should have been on time. Now you're variant. And now they gotta wipe you. And or correct the timeline. Code for, like, probably gonna die. They're going to cleanse you from the timeline. Oh, hoister? I don't feel so well. Why do you keep puking? Blarr, I should get this fixed. There's a doctor out there somewhere. He just picked it up too, like that. Hey, hi. Who are you? What are you doing here? Could ask you the same. I live here and guard the flesh kraken. Now what are you doing here? Came from the back facility. You came through the door. That's working. Apparently. You know about the machines down there? No. Didn't know there were any. But you hurt me. Yes. Oh shit! I thought I would, like, you never know. Maybe I probably shouldn't have said that, but that's fine. Yeah. I got the sitcoms, I didn't like them. Never have. Loki was one thing I remembered in Infinity War. The timeline that reminds me of the timekeepers in Discworld. Where a police officer ended up back in time and ended up having to be his old commander teaching himself. I did hear people like speculating of like maybe the lizard creatures are dead. Maybe Loki's the one that's in charge. Maybe he's got to be the one. You can save the game manually when not in combat. Okay. Am I technically in combat because I told her I was going to take her out? Like, I wonder if I could apologize. I'm sorry. I'm new here. I think I was just recently created. Real weird when you think about it. The biggest thing that the thing that I'm thinking, because I just watched the recent episode of Loki, is the TVA is the bad guys, right? Because they're a dictatorship. I do wonder if they're gonna try to make, can't have enough of those. Enough of what? Citizenship revoked. Read, citizen. You're sad to inform me that you are unfit to continue living among us. Effective immediately, your citizenship has been revoked. You've been released to the surface world to continue your life separate from our universal society. Please follow the regulations of the free world. Number one, do not, under any circumstance, enter a settlement under settlement of the universal society. Number two, do not reproduce. If you break any of these rules, you would be terminated. If you need advice on how to live your life on the surface, please ask an integration assistant for more info. We wish you a happy life outside of our society. Don't bang anybody, chap. There's another one. Okay, so clearly somebody broke the rule. Ooh. That man is naked. Why is that man naked? Ah, it's always good to have a little bit of brains. Hello, naked man. Hey, old man.
I look at you wearing clothes so serious, huh?
I mean, clothes are very practical. Like I said, serious. Hey, look at my dancing skills. Now I celebrate the sun. Now, off you go. How is nobody bugging the naked old guy? Why is nobody bugging the naked old guy? Mind the fact that there are multi-use of Lokis out there? Oh yeah, no, it totally is. Which I'm doing. Okay, so hold up. I got a little bit of a theory here. Is in preparation for Multiverse of Madness, the whole like red line they refer to in Loki, once that breaks, the event's just gonna screw up. Basically, somebody's gonna cause something to happen, and in other words, multiverse, and then maybe hitting the red line, it just creates madness. And yeah, there's also an idea that's been running around on the internet, and part of me would like to see it, part of me wouldn't. Kang the Conqueror? Scout Command. Knowledge Fragment. Inexperience. Oh, good.
Travel west when Taurus. Look out for any signs of the big ones. Or back if you find one. Don't approach it. Be careful. Mutes seem to be very aggressively. Something's riling them up and it's probably going to get worse.
Memorize. Oh, you can memorize it? Cool. Don't know what that means. I'm assuming I don't have to read it again. You finished it. That was so convoluted, whatever. The kids will continue the journey. Breaking, which is scary. I love the old style cartoon introduction about the TVA. Yep. It was actually great to see Tara Strong voice that character, by the way. I think for me though, like Falcon the Winter Soldier and Loki, like right up there. Chop, chop, eat meat. Eat meat, eat meat. It's cheap. Eat meat, meat, meat. Seriously, I don't know why anyone would complain about cheap meat. It's not like animals can't kill for this one. Oh. I mean, fire meat over here. Fresh meat for everyone. Hey, you're new here, right? Here's your meat. Complimentary meat on the house. Actually, on the ground. We take care of everyone. If you want more, though, you have to pay. What's with all the meat everywhere? It's just there. Gross. Oh, and it takes craftsmanship to pick the best pieces, of course. Yeah, but where does it come from? Honestly, I don't know. As far as I remember, it always has been growing everywhere, right from the ground. Maybe we're living on a planet full of flesh, and right now we're standing on a crust of stone and dirt. So, you want a piece of meat now, or is it safe to eat raw? Yeah, everyone around here does. Okay, they got a meat statue. Hi, what's your name? Max. Nice to meet you, Max. I'm Custer. Want to do a job for the collectors? It's well paid. Let's say I do. Well, at a bit of a hard spot right now. Contact of the collectors told me that they're looking for a functioning machine core. I know there's a bunker in the north of the edge of the mountains. I reckon it's still fully equipped. It's on my way, but I got bitten by one of those worms. Still recovering from that. That machine core worth much? To the collectors it is. They always pay well. The stuff is quality. But you get, how about you get it, then come back, and I'll lead us to the buyer. Okay, cool. Bunker 17 is to the northeast of here, the foot of the mountains. You'll find it. Good luck, Max. Okay, if I take this stuff, is this bad? Booze, meat, booze. Shibazu, the seducer. Oh, this game's like an acid trip. Okay. You know, and it's not wrong. Like, it's a blending of, like, perfection. Just food and sex. Yeah. A little bit with the WandaVision stuff crossing over to Loki. Or maybe it's old because the TVA is old. Well, the TVA also might... Okay, so... The Tesseract and the Infinity Stones, which... Boy, was that like a... Like a nice little nod of me, like they use them as paperweights. Nobody seems to know what a fish is. Like all these weird little things. There's only one place that would give that sort of loophole that I can think of that they've already mentioned before. The atomic zone, right? Like when Ant-Man goes like subatomic, I'm thinking that's where the TVA belongs. I'm thinking that's. Like, there's somewhere in there, and that's where they operate. Which means that those doors are essentially a really cheap and dirty way to get into, an easy way to get into the subatomic world. Because Ant-Man was not affected, and they don't seem to really kind of operate in that universe. So, yeah. Did Asgard really get destroyed in Ragnarok? Yes. Yeah, I don't know. The lava horn dude totally wrecked it, and then Helga got really upset because naturally that's her kingdom getting destroyed, and so she went ham on the dude. Which we don't. I'm assuming she's dead, but we don't actually see her die. So you know the rules about like. Ow! Damn. Well, that's unleashly forgiving. You know the rules about movies. You don't see it. Doesn't mean it's happened. Right? Gotta be on screen for it to count. Kind of digging this game, by the way.
Hey, boys. Oh, boy.
Wait. Why do you get a buddy? That's a flesh monster. Wait. They dropped their weapons, chat. I really do love it when they drop their weapons. All right. This is actually I'm kind of digging this game. It's a little grotesque in certain aspects, but yeah, I'm actually yes. Oh shit, biscuits. Oh god. So having it on anything higher than hard might be problematic. Yeah.
Oh, I'm out of ammo.
Most likely not dead, but he ain't back yet. Well, that's the thing is, Zap, have you been watching or have any desire to watch Bad Batch? It is the new Dave Filoni TV show. I've talked about it before. It takes place between the prequel movies and the old Star Wars movies. Like when the Empire was at its peak of strength, right? They were taking over everything and going to town and all of that. I'm kind of wondering if we might see Mace Windu during that phase. It's latest episode, by the way. Mwah! Getting pretty good. Not even the Skywalker saga. You know how Disney likes to kill off characters, no blood or anything. Yeah. Well, the thing is, they could easily put a CGI character in Bad Batch, right? Like, you don't have to even get Samuel L. Jackson, because they have, I think it was Phil Lamar who voiced, no, it wasn't Phil. Somebody else had voiced Mace Windu in the Clone Wars. The anime Clone Wars. Nothing but the anime Clone Wars series. Ah, oh, it's such a good series. Oh my god. Some of the best characterization. Like, look, I'm gonna say this. Anyone in chat that's a huge Star Wars fan, anyone on YouTube, I'm sorry. But, I like the movies. Empire Strike Back is my favorite, but Clone Wars animated series is so much better. And part of that is because they have more time to develop characters, which is totally true. But in general, it's leagues better. It's just so much better. Damn. That's hard. Especially with a 2-for-1. Do I have? I don't think I have a grenade. I should have gone with more strength. Yo! There's a good chance we're gonna play this. I'm gonna walk out, walk back in. And then that's what I want right there. Get that gun! It's an old rifle too! Is that better than what I have? Oh, it's the same. All right. Deconstruct. Missing crafting knowledge. Is there durability? Hey, chat. No durability. I will eat the organs. Level 2. Ooh, sawed-off shotgun, projectiles. Equip that. There is different ammo time, too. Mm-hmm. All right, so I've reached level 2. Skills. Rifles. apply. Hey, skills and stats are separate. Oh, I like. Oh, handy. Okay. Yeah, this is a good game. Running and producing electricity. Good. I don't have to puke on it. I need a lockpick, though. The sun takes another and another one down. Oh my god, come here, cutie. What did I just do? I took him. I can't eat him. But why did we do that? Cyan key. All right, I got a cutie chat. Oh, cyan key is probably for that door. Okay. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna leave and then come back in. Cause I wanna make sure we save. There we go. Yeah, this is a really good game. Kinda grody. Not gonna lie. There's a game. When I first started streaming, there was a, it's a really fun game with friends, both locally or online, called Crawl. And it's a weird little thing where when you go into a room, you and up to four friends will vie for the possession of a hero. Once you're in the hero's body, all of your friends become your enemies. They can then possess monsters to try to kill you. If they get the killing blow, they get to be the hero. And then you just kind of reverse and blah, 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 blah. And then when you get to the boss, all of the people can then go in to the boss in different parts of the boss and do different attacks while your friend is trying to survive. The one who survives the longest gets to live. Gets to win. It is called Crawl. The art style is very similar to this game right here. I don't know if it's done by the same people. But, ah, damn it. That's exactly why. Do I need to watch the Clone Wars anime series before watching Bad Batch? Not necessarily, no. It's one of those things where if you do, you're probably going to get more info out of it, like more backstory. There's going to be a lot more... The art style in this game reminds me, and the sounds, is this from the same guys behind Crawl? Because if it is, hot damn, boys. You're good at making the sexy shit. Oh, shotgun at close range. Wouldn't you know it? It's awesome. Ba-da-da. But yeah, if you decide to watch Bad Batch, you don't necessarily have to watch Clone Wars, but you do get all the characters you do see in Bad Batch. You have that like emotional attachment, very similar to well, actually, it's not quite. The reason I'm saying this is if you see like Cad Bane, which is a bounty hunter, you're like, oh my god, it's Cad. He's back. He's a badass. Like better than Boba Fett. Better than Jango Fett. He doesn't die. Like a little bitch. But the thing is, the Bad Batch cast themselves, you don't need to have a whole lot of info. If they're only very recent. So you get more fleshed out in their actual series. Might have seen someone play Crawl once. It's been a while for now. Yeah, no, Crawl was a really, really fun game back in the day. Are Clone Wars and Bad Batch canon? Yes. They're actually canon. One of the few things Disney did right is when they were going through and kind of like butchering everything and like just cutting everything apart, they kept that. There's a hole in it. Somebody must have gutted the insides. I think we have enough healing eye. Oh, wait a minute. Refreshing and intoxicating sickness. Man, this is good.
I can puke like the best of them.
Ew. Absolutely grody. This is such a weird game, but I'm loving this game. I'm gonna run back because I have no meat to survive from. Phoenix, morning. Can I give you a Disney title and you tell me if you've seen it or not? Sure, hit me. Luca. Nope. Seeing that tomorrow. I had a buddy of mine do a review on it, though. His impression of Luca was, it's okay. It a little nonsensical here and there, but it's okay. Owned by somebody.
Hey, close that door.
Oh, I'm sorry, miss.
Oh.
What'd you want? Just looking around. Getting
to know people?
Something like that, I guess.
Well, I'm Marla. I'm old, so just stay here most of the time. I'm friends with everyone.
Everyone?
Yeah, Agra's best, though. She takes care of me. I even brought me cheese that one day. Only time I had some apart from my cyber womb. Anything else?
Just looking around. Getting to know the people. Oh, and we're back around. Okay.
Then please leave.
Okay. Now I'll shut the door. I do love that she's like, hey, shut that damn door. All right. All right. I've seen the trailer and I was entertained by it. It looks cute. Luca really does look cute. Zap brought Raya and the Last Dragon up, which I enjoyed that movie quite a bit. Con Baby is best baby. Really is. Hello, do you need anything? Browse services. Healing. Cool. Thank you. Dude, it's actually full. A lot of flasks and trinkets. Owned by someone. Hey, do you mind if I use your bed? There's some crusty puke on it. Never mind. Look, everything's trash. They literally call this game Death Trash. But I gotta have some standards, chat. I draw the line somewhere. Like this place. Almost feels like home now. I admit I was angry when they threw me out. Unstable mind. Pussies. But it's all good now. Just miss the cyber womb sometimes. It's a crime. Crime? Getting thrown out? What'd you do?
Nothing. It's due to medical reasons.
Why exactly?
Infectious reasons.
I think it's better if you keep some distance from me now. Yeah. Love that you're here, though. Go away.
All right.
This is great. This is great. Well, lately I use Disney Plus for Criminal Minds. I loved Rhea.
Rhea was good.
Cat, morning, buddy. Got to Shantytown and Bioshock Infinite. It's good so far, but I like the first two games more. If the rumors are true, Cap, they're making a Bioshock remake. Oh my God, 2K, you gotta make Bioshock 2 remake. That was not like rhyming or anything. It was just completely offbeat. But give me the big sister from Bioshock 2. Give us scripted events, but give us like Mr. T, Mr. X level of like chase sequences where she's climbing in through the walls, puncturing through like vents, like coming out of the damn ground, banging through doors and walls, and just terrorizing you as a player. That would be awesome. Give us the original intent of that game and I will love you long time. Yes. Stranger, I don't trust the machines. Okay, Naked man.
Ah, nice, fellow traveler. People over here are a bit weird, though. I look for some food, but they only serve raw meat. Ugh. Back to eating plants dirt, I guess. Well, see ya.
I love how the crazy guy is the naked guy, and yet he's eating the healthy stuff.
Ah, don't push me.
Focus, energy, already full. Focus energy. This feels... I'm going to say this. This feels like an action-packed version of Fallout 1. Like, even the way this is set right here, it feels like very Fallout 1. Oh.
Yes. Now I'm ready for the pandemic.
Got a good clean mask on, my boy. Move along. Please maintain peaceful behavior.
Oh god, 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 don't do that. I'm sorry! Oh shit. You could almost kind of kill them. Almost kind of. I'm peace. Oh, I'm peace. Oh yeah, I forgot we have our little flesh kraken thingies in my pocket. You know, I wondered, will they are they upset with us permanently? No. Okay.
They'll say they need to do a nemesis type enemy called Big Brother.
Well, originally you had the Big Daddies, right? Those were the lumbering brutes in BioShock 1. When BioShock like took off, Ken Levine, the B team that was working on BioShock 2, the creative designer was like, you know what we need to do is we want to have a big sister. We want her to path around like the Big Daddies, but to be more antagonizing, more aggressive to the player, while also still having scripted events. We really want to almost harass the player and keep them always tense, right? Only certain areas will ever let you feel relaxed and feel safe. But 2K, due to the urge and like just desire to get out BioShock 2 as fast as humanly possible, because how well the first one sold, they cut all of that AI design and programming. And the sad thing is they hadn't technically finished the AI, but they were in the process of debugging and just kind of tweaking it to be less buggy. That was it. And we could have had like a Mr. X, Mrs. X style like creature running around just scaring the hell out of you. And it would have been great. And to be the same big sister the whole time. And each iteration of fighting them, very similar to the Resident Evil 3 Nemesis, you kill her or you put her in a down state. You take something from her, and that'll help you fight her the next time around. But since you removed something from her, she's going to change up her tactics the next fight. If you escaped or had escaped, then she would maintain her tactics to kind of give this illusion of like she's adapting to you, right? And the whole idea was just, it sounded amazing. And I would really love to see that. That's kind of what I was excited for BioShock Infinite back in the day, because Ken Levine in one of the interviews had talked about that weird, creepy bird thing was supposed to have a similar mechanic, and that got cut. Like a lot of things got cut from Infinite that just, yeah. Like even the idea of, what's her name? Your companion character in Infinite. Like, she was supposed to have a bigger role in combat. Did you guys ever see that slice of life they did for that game? Oh my god. Like, if we ever got that now, that'd be amazing.
In need of my services.
What is this machine next to you?
It's a machine merchant. Fine thing, right? Collectors installed it.
Collectors?
Bunch of traders looking for rare scrap, but interested in all kind of goods, really. Ever heard of them?
Where are you from? There. Expelled from society.
Well, aren't we all? Some of us have been here for a while, though. How long? Decades. The place itself has been here way longer. Anyways, someone else you want it? Can you teach me anything? Well, I know a thing or two about fixing things and breaking things. Actually had a handy guide about it with some basics. Told it to a guy that was heading west. Anything else? What you got? Reset visuals. Let's you reselect the visuals of your character. Hey, you can actually undo your stats. I like that. All right, go ahead and sell that twice. Sell that. What is the point of the flesh animal? I'm gonna drop one of the fleshies. Oh, drop it. Come on, little buddy. Ow. You dick. Huh. Well, I got food. That happened. That ended so much better than, like, Lassie chat. So much better. One of the Monsters, Inc. movies coming out. Monsters at Work. Actually, yeah, I was going to say, it's not a movie. It's a series. From what I heard, it is a 8-episode series. It could be good. It could be real good. Wasn't what I was not expecting it, but yeah.